Hello. This message is to you, Jared. You, Jared, Caleb, Christopher, Coleman. I love you. You're so amazing. You probably won't see this until, you know, how you have those moments when you log on and you scroll. You're just looking for your name. Oh, well, maybe this one is about me, but I talk about you on a scale from 1 to 10, if there's 10 videos, I talk about you in at least 8 of the videos. You're such an integral part of my life. You really, really are. I try to be the best mom that I know how to be. I'm always trying to challenge myself with this thing called grace, because there's times that you may do things that I don't agree with, or even I don't understand, and I have to grant you more grace than my flesh wants to. But I remind myself, well, God actually reminds me that it's new for you and it's also new for me, because remember, I allowed Jay and Janaea to go with their dad early. They were being a little rambunctious, as you know, and so a lot of these things is new for me too. The teen, the tween, and, you know, having a boy and raising a boy alone. So I just want to thank you for just being so patient with your mom. You've taught me a lot. You've really taught me how to soul search. And mom, should you have said that, mom, is that the right thing? You're always checking me spiritually in a loving and caring way, but it always makes me think. You know, I have so much gratefulness to God and gratitude towards you to just always loving me unconditionally, and you do. I couldn't even ask for a more dedicated and loyal and loving son than you. I pray that, not that we grow old together, because of course you're not going to be a mama's boy, you know, you're going to be married to a wonderful, beautiful Christian Jesus follower young lady. Doesn't matter how tall, short, thin, size, color, as long as we serve the same God, she's straight, you know. But I do. I look forward to just watching you grow up, mature, grow older, even like today, how you wanted to make sure you had yourself together and you had your suit on. You looked amazing. You did. So by the time I get home, though, you'll have your suit off. Your leg will be cocked up on the couch, eating cereal, watching TV, waiting for me to get home so I can take you to the fire station. But I just want to say thank you. That's all. I love you. I pray that, well, right now you're 12. I'm 41. I'll be 42 in February, that you always remind me, Mom, your birthday's before Valentine's Day. But if God permits it, scripturally speaking, and how things are going in the world, I really don't see how or even want to be here that long for me to even see you get married, unless you get married in your teens. But you're in seventh grade now. I really foresee the Lord coming while you're in high school. So, of course, no man knows the day nor the hour, but when he comes, I just pray that I am ready to go up hither. And I pray you too are ready to go up hither. And I apologize for some days that I'm just like crazy. You know, it's like, Jared, why'd you do this? And da 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 da. But even after my fuss, and I come back and I apologize. And that's one thing that you've taught me too. Even from the womb, you taught me how to apologize quickly, forgive quickly. And I'm trying to embrace that and take that same thing on to other individuals. I'm still a work in progress, because I'm still trying to love ungrudgingly. Yeah, okay. Because my test is dealing with family, and it's been hard. But you teach me and help me to be not just a better mom, a better woman, a better individual, better Christ follower, a better mentor, a better worker. Even when I've complained at work, you've come back, well, Mom, at least you have a job. You know, when you used to hear me complain about my our previous boss, like, you've helped me. You've helped me. You've shown me the light in a dark situation. Even if it's dim, even if I think it's dark, you show me, Mom, it really isn't dark. Your attitude is making it dark. So I just said, my God, I've raised an amazing son, but I've also been blessed to been able to birth an amazing son, because what's in you comes out. I believe that God already placed these things in you, and he just entrusted me to help pull those things out of you that were already there. He birthed you before you enter into my womb. God knew. He already made you. Your life was already mapped out. Your life was already planned. Meaning, who you are now is already how God saw you. And it's my job as a parent to find out what those things are in you, mold them, pull out the good, recognize the bad, deal with the bad, nip the bad, tear up the bad, but we don't want to throw it away. Let's talk about it. Let's analyze it. Let's deal with it so we can even learn from the negative things and the situations in our life. Some is like ministry, when people have spiritual fathers, spiritual mothers, they're supposed to see what's in their child. Sometimes the child already knows, sometimes they don't. They help them discover who they are. And if the child is discovering who they are themselves by their own self-study, their own situations they've learned for, self-taught, things like that, it's for them to, well, not for them, it's for us as parents to capitalize on what they already know and build from there. So I said all this to say, I love you. Thank you for allowing me to be your mom. I mean, granted, by birth, I'm your mother on paper, but our relationship and the bond that we share, you open up your heart and allow me to be your mom. I'm about to cry. So I just wanted to say thank you. I love you, Jared. You're amazing. And the same love I have for you, of course, I have it for your brother and sister, Jalen and Janae, as well. God's going to help us with that process with them as well. So as you always pray for me, of course, I'm always praying for you. But let's also keep Jalen and Janae in mind as well. It's never out of sight, out of mind, although it's easy to be like that. But our heartstrings, our connection to Christ, it won't allow it. So just thank you for who you are and who you're going to be. So thanks, Jared. You're amazing. What's today? December 4th, 2014. And it is 8:20 in the morning. And I have you on my mind. Love you, honey. Have a good day. You do an amazing job, too, at processing things you've gone through as far as basically kind of like being an only child and your siblings not really being there, uncles, aunts, your dad, stuff like that. I just think that you're so strong. Sometimes it offends me that you're so strong and you're so young and you shouldn't have to be that way. But God just, again, he made you. You were birthed like this. He knew all this would take place in your life and you're able to get through it. Not saying you don't have your moments, not saying you don't have your days, but he built you. He built us to bend and not break. So that's another thing I just wanted to commend you on. That's all. I've shared that with you several times, but there's nothing wrong with, just celebrating people while they're still alive. There's nothing wrong with giving genuine, heartfelt compliments, saying you're doing a good job and I'm proud of you, which I am. I love you, Jared. You're amazing. All right, love muffin. See you in 6 hours. Okay. Bye, honey. Bye-bye.